Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller from Eyes on the Sky. NGC 457, as a deep sky object name, doesn't sound very exciting, so let me provide you with a few more colorful ones for this open star cluster. The Owl Cluster, the Dragonfly Cluster, the ET Cluster. The question then is, what will you see when you find it? At nearly 8,000 light years away, NGC 457 is one of the more distant open clusters that we will view in this catalog of 40 objects. The two eyes are magnitudes 5 and 7 respectively, with the remaining stars largely around 12th to 15th magnitude. While the dimmer ones will be difficult to see in smaller telescopes or under severe light pollution, the general shape of the cluster is still readily seen from most places. And the brighter eyes make it easy to find. Let's learn how. To find NGC 457, look for the W or M shape of the constellation Cassiopeia in the northern sky. If you're not sure where to look for it, check out my Shapes in the Sky Cassiopeia video for how to find it. A link to that is in the description of this video. Although NGC 457 is closer to Delta Cassiopeiae, we will start from the central star in the M, Navi, located here. Then a short move about 3 degrees this way will help us reach the cluster. More on that in a moment. With a magnified finder scope with a 7 degrees field of view, center the star Navi. This star is second magnitude, but there's a fifth magnitude star very close to it that most finder scopes should also show. If not, use the red dot finder method I described next. We will use these two stars to aim towards the cluster. Draw a line from the dimmer star through Navi, and then place Navi at the very edge of your field of view. At this point, you should already be able to see the fifth magnitude star of one eye of the cluster, and perhaps the seventh magnitude dimmer eye. Then center that area in your finder scope. For telescopes with a red dot finder, this cluster is a bit more challenging, but it can be found. We will look at two stars and imagine a triangle shape for the third point. Start at Navi, then move towards Delta Cassiopeiae. Then turn at a right angle outside from Cassiopeia's shape, about 2/3 of the distance of the stars that you can see in the triangle we are imagining. Your red dot finder should be located about here. That should place the cluster in a low magnification eyepiece view. If not, slowly spiral around the area until the eyes of the cluster come into view. Or if you can see the 3.7 magnitude star Zeta Cassiopeiae that is just off the star Shedar, use that same line to draw a parallel line from Delta a similar distance. As always, start with low magnification to center the object first. With this cluster, it is best framed somewhere between 1 degree for the telescopic field of view. Then look at the body of the shape below the brighter eye star. Can you see the more orange looking star here? That is a pulsating variable M-class star reaching the end of its life. The color difference here should be striking. If you liked this video and it helped you find this object successfully, check out the other 39 telescopes on the sky objects. I'll lead you step by step to the best and easiest objects to find from the Northern Hemisphere. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel by clicking the subscribe button just below this video to the right on YouTube. I make regular updates on how to find all kinds of interesting objects in the sky, naked eye, with binoculars, telescopes, and occasional reviews too, and have since 2010. Thanks for watching. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.